You are the student of class 8. Today we are going to start chapter flow 4, playing with the numbers. Playing with the numbers. You know that suppose that 23 is a two-digit number. Here unit digit is 3 and tens digit is 2. How will you find the formula to find the two-digit number? It is read as two tens plus 3 unit and 45. It is also read as 4 tens plus 5 unit. Therefore, we can say that a formula to find the two digit number, it is equal to 10 into tens digit plus unit digit. 10 into tens digit plus unit digit. Now, similarly, suppose that 465 is a three-digit number. It is once unit digit is 5, tens digit is 6, and 100 digit is 4. It is also written as 100 into 4, 400s plus 610. 10 into 6 plus unit digit 5. So we get 3 digit number formula. 3 digit number. It is equal to 100 into 100 digit plus 10 into tens digit, S for 100 digit, T for tens digit, and U for unit digit. 3 digit number is equal to 100 into 100 digit plus 10 into tens digit plus unit digit. This is the formula to find the 3 digit number. Dear student, your chapter is playing with the numbers. Now we will play with the numbers. You know very well what is the test of divisibility of the number. Test of divisibility by 2. How will you find which number is divisible by 2? For example, we get 10. Its unit place is 0. It is divisible by 2. Now we take 12. Its unit place is 2, it is also divisible by 2. Now take 14, it is even, unit digit is even, it is also divisible by 2. So we see that which number is divisible by 2. If any number has 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8, or even digit on its unit place, then that number must be divisible by 2. These numbers has 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 on the unit place, therefore this number is divisible by 2. Now, test of divisibility by 3. Now we see that 123. We see that here this number is divisible by 3 or not. How will you find without dividing, how will you find this number is divisible by 3 or not? If you will add the sum of the digit 1 plus 2 plus 3, it is equal to 6. and 6 is divisible by 6 is completely divisible by 3. Therefore, 123 must be divisible by 3. So we conclude that what is the test of divisibility by 3? If sum of the digits of any number is divisible by 3, then that number must be divisible by 3. Now we will find which number are divisible by 5. Suppose that 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. All these numbers are divisible by 5. Why? Its unit place is 5 or its unit place is 0, either 5 or 0. Then we conclude that if any number has 5 or 0 on its unit place, then that number must be divisible by 5. I have discussed test of divisibility of 2, 3 and 5. Now we will give the test of divisibility by 4. If the number formed by the last two digits in any number, if the number formed by the last two digits of the number is divisible by 4, then that number must be divisible by 4. Otherwise not. Let us take first example 672. Here unit digit is 2 and tens digit is 7. The number formed by the last two digits is 72, and 72 is divisible by 4. 4 1 ja 4, 2 remainder, 2 bring down, 4 8 ja 32. The number formed by the last two digits is divisible by 4. Therefore, the given number must be divisible by 4. If you will divide 672 by 4, then it is divisible. 672, 4 1 is 4, 2 is remainder, bring down 7, 4 6 is 24, 3 is remainder, bring down 2, 4 8 is 32. We see that here 672 must be divisible by 4. But if we take another example, 686, here unit digit is 6 and tens digit is 8. Here 86 is not completely divisible by 4. 4 1 is 4, 2 is the remainder. Here the number formed by the last two digits, unit and tens digit, it is not divisible by 4. It gives 2 remainder. Therefore, this number is not divisible by 4. Why? Because the number formed by this last two digits is not completely divisible by 4. Then this number is not divisible by 4. So it was the test of divisibility by 4. Now we will explain test of divisibility by 8. If the number formed by last three digits is divisible by 8, then that number must be divisible by 8. In the first question, 7304. The number formed by last three digits is 304. Now we see that it is divisible by 8 or not. It goes 8 3 is 24. 6 remainder, bring down 4. Then it will become 64. 8 8 is 64. And there is no remainder. Therefore, 7304 is divisible by A. But we see in the second problem, in 8612, the number formed by the last three digits is 612. Now we see that if this number is divisible by 8 or not. We see here the number 612. We take two digits, 8 7 56, 5 remainder, 2 bring down. Now 8 6 48, 4 remainder. We see that this number 612 is not divisible by 8. It gives 4 as remainder. So this number is not divisible by 8. Now test of divisibility by 10. If a number has unit less 0, then that number must be divisible by 10. For example, 10, 20, 100, 1000. In all these numbers, we see that its unit place is 0, then we can say that these numbers are divisible by 10. हम लोग जब टेस्ट ऑफ डिविजिबिलिटी बाय 11 करते हैं तो हम लोग सबसे पहले यह करते हैं कि ऑड प्लेसेस को टोटल कर लेते हैं और इवन डिजिट के टोटल को ऐड कर लेते हैं, फिर उन दोनों का डिफरेंस निकालते हैं. अगर डिफरेंस 0 है या डिफरेंस 11 से डिविजिबल है तो हम कहते हैं कि वह नंबर 11 से डिविजिबल होगा, अदरवाइज नॉट. मींस एनी नंबर इज डिविजिबल बाय 11 इफ द सम द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द सम ऑफ इट्स ऑड डिजिट एंड द सम ऑफ इट्स इवन डिजिट इज आइदर 0 आर डिविजिबल बाय 11. सो सम ऑफ ऑन डिजिट्स हियर यूनिट डिजिट इज ऑड एंड 100 डिजिट इज ऑड, 4 + 2 इज इक्वल टू 6 एंड 10th digit is even and 1000th digit is even. Then sum of even digits is equal to 1 + 5 is equal to 6. Both are 6. Then therefore difference between them, difference between them is 0. So 1452 is divisible by 11. Now we will check second part. Similarly, we can do it. 6 + 4 is equal to 10. This is the sum of odd places. Now we will find the sum of even places. 9 + 1 is equal to 10. And difference is also 0. Therefore, this number are divisible by 11. Alright. Now, I am giving a problem where one digit is missed. It is the missing number X. How will you find the missing number X? Find all possible values of X for which the number 5, 3, 4, X, 2 is divisible by 3. Now, we know that any number is divisible by 3 if the sum of its the digit, it must be divisible by 3. So, first, we will add all the digit of the given number. And this is 5 plus 3 plus 4 plus x plus 2. This number must be divisible by 3. So we get here 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 4, 12, 12 plus 2 is equal to 14. 14 plus x. 5, 3, 8, 4, 12, 12 to 14, 14 plus x. Now we know that this sum must be divisible by 3. So first we take the number which is divisible by 3 and it should be greater than 14. We see that the number greater than 14, just for greater than 14, which is divisible by 3 is 15. It is the least number that is divisible by 3. Now, 14 plus x is equal to 15. So, x is equal to 15 minus 14, that is equal to 1. First value of x is 1. Now, second value greater than 15 is 18. So, 14 plus x must be equal to 18. So, x is equal to 18 minus 14, it is equal to 4. And then, third number, we get 21. After 18, it is 21. Now we write 14 plus x, this is the answer and this is the answer. 14 plus x is equal to 21. 21 is divisible by 3. Now x is equal to 21 minus 14. It is equal to 7. Then we can find all other values, so on. So answer is 147 dot dot. Answer is 147 dot dot, and so on. In this chapter, all things are given. I hope that using these methods and tests, you can solve all problems of this chapter. Thank you very much.